हो गया हो गया हो गया। हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। हेलो,
यस
यस, कैन यू
सर,
हियर?
यस सर।
ओके, एक्चुअली देयर वाज अ नेटवर्क इश्यू, आई डोंट नो व्हाट हैड हैपेंड। नाउ इट्स ऑल राइट, इट ऑटोमेटिकली गॉट डिसकनेक्टेड। कुड यू हियर मी क्लियरली? यस, ओके। एंड द बोर्ड इज विजिबल टू यू? यस और नो?
यस सर।
ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी बिगिन विद द वर्ड ऑफ द डे, दैट इज एल्ड्रिज।
एल्ड्रिज,
ई एल
वियर्ड,
डी आर आई टी सी एच, एल्ड्रिज, एंड द मीनिंग इज ईयरी और वियर्ड और स्पूकी। ओके, वियर्ड, वेरी स्ट्रेंज, eerie, all these are the meaning of the word. The chapter which we are going to read, which we are going to begin today, it is The Hack Driver, written by an American novelist, American author, American writer, that is Sinclair Lewis. Remember, he is an American writer, American author, and he is the first American who got Nobel Prize for Literature. If you read in the introduction, you would come to know that he is the first writer or the first American author who got Nobel Prize for Literature. Now, as I was asking you about the chapter, how many of you have gone through the chapter? Only one or two students, they told me that yes, we have read the chapter, we have gone through the chapter, they have read the summary and the characters. So let us just discuss about the summary and the characters which we are going to read about in the story, and then we can read about them in detail. So whosoever is going to tell the summary to the class, he or she can raise their hand. So who is it first? Tell me, who is going to tell the class the summary of the chapter? Who is it? Tell me. Is there anyone who is going to? No one? What about the two guys, those who had said?
Sir, that? I have raised my hand.
But I can't see you. Where are you? Who has raised hand? Charvi? How you are?
Sir,
not,
Charvi.
You are not visible. Your hand is not visible here. Okay. Your name is there. Okay, no issue. Charvi is there. Okay. And one more girl was there. Okay. So read, say Charvi in your own words, and rest of you all listen to what she says. Understand the summary. Understand the characters. Yes, Charvi, go ahead.
Yes, sir. Sir, the story Hack Driver is about where the narrator is a detective sort of job he does, and he is actually bored with his job because he does not have to solve the cases but bring the people who are needed for solving the case from different places. So once he was sent to a town called New Malian and was ordered to find Oliver Lutkins. So Oliver Lutkins was needed for their case, and the narrator went to New Malian, and he was severely disappointed by looking at the condition of the village, and it was all with mud, and either the wooden shops were there and no paints were there like that. So he did not enjoy going to that village. Finally, he met a hack driver, to whom he asked that he wants to find Oliver Lutkins. So the hack driver named Bill, he suggested that I saw him around here about an hour ago. So the person Bill helped the author, the narrator, to find Bill all across the city, all across the village, going from here and there. But they could not catch Slutkins. And actually Bill took the narrator to many, many places, even to the Bill's mother, even to Oliver's mother, but they couldn't find Oliver Lutkins. Finally, the next day, the narrator once again came to this village with one of his companion, and that companion told him the person you are assuming to be Bill is not only Oliver Lutkins, and he helped you to find Oliver Lutkins himself. So that was the irony in the situation, in the story, that the narrator was finding Oliver Lutkins, and Oliver Lutkins himself was helping the narrator to find himself.
Yes. Understood, everybody? Yes or no? Got something? Understood?
Yes.
Something you might have.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So if you have not done. Hello.
Yes, sir.
The connection is not stable. Some problem is there again and again. It's being disconnected and connected again. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we were talking about the chapter, The Hack Driver, and Charvi Gupta has said the summary in her own words. Now, I hope many of you have understood what is in the chapter, but still for others, those who have not got, I just narrate the story in my own words. So the author of the chapter, that is Sinclair Lewis, he, after his graduation, he started working as an assistant clerk with law firm. Now you know what is a job of a lawyer. So it was a law firm. It used to find the cases and solve the different cases, whatever the client asked for. And he was working as an assistant clerk there. But he was not satisfied. He was not satisfied because he was not given the opportunity to practice law. Rather, he was given a clerical job. He was given a job of delivering the notice or summons or any other legal document, preparation of legal document, what a clerk does. So therefore, he did not like his job. He was not happy. He was dissatisfied with his working condition and with his job. So somewhere in his heart, he also had desire to go back to some other firm and to change his job, to change the place. But one day, it happened that he was given a task by his owner, by the company where he was working. And the task was to go and deliver a summon to a person called Oliver Lutkin. he was given a task to deliver a summon. Now summon is given by the court. The court gives a legal notice to someone for coming to the court and presenting their views. So that is called the summon. Now he got that job to present the summon, the legal document to Mr. Oliver Lutkin. So he was a little bit excited first, initially thought that he is getting a chance to visit a small village. आओ देखो अपने आप से डिस्कनेक्ट हो रहा है फिर कनेक्टिंग हो रहा है ये ऑटोमेटिकली कनेक्ट हो गया लेकिन अपने आप से फिर डिस्कनेक्ट भी हो रहा है हाँ बच्चे हैं ना रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन कर दिया ओके सो एज आई वॉज टेलिंग यू अबाउट द कैरेक्टर सिंक्लेयर लुइस द ऑथर ही वॉज गिवन अ टास्क टू डिलीवर अ समन अ लीगल नोटिस टू मिस्टर ओलिवर लटकिन ही वेंट देयर एंड आफ्टर रीचिंग द स्टेशन ही सो अ हैक ड्राइवर So you understand what is a hack driver, a cart man, okay, or a person who uses the horses and other cart for carrying passenger from one place to another place. So he was having that service, and he was a man whom the author Sinclair Lewis trust. He called the cab. He sat. And he told him about the man. He said that I want to give the notice to Oliver Lutkin. Now the person who told himself that he is a hack driver, actually you would come to know later on that he himself was Lutkin, Oliver Lutkin. He himself was Oliver Lutkin, but he hides his identity and he uses another name, that is Bill Magnuson. He calls himself that I am a hack driver and my name is Bill Magnuson. And he cooks very good story about Oliver Lutkin, about himself, in order to win the faith and the confidence of the lawyer. Seeing his dress, he was wearing a lawyer dress, so seeing the dress he understood that this is a lawyer and he has come for some legal work. So he tells him that if you go and find him in this dress, you may not meet him, because he is very cunning, he is very clever. So he tells him that I can find you helping, I can help you finding this man, but I will charge $2 per hour. He said that I will charge you $2 per hour and I can go wherever you like me to go in searching of the man. So the lawyer agreed. Lawyer thought that he is a very kind man, very good man. He was so much influenced by the hospitality or kind, good, positive behavior of hack driver. But he didn't know that the person who is behaving so smartly, so lovingly, so kindly himself is Oliver Lutkin, the person for whom he is searching and to whom he had to deliver the summon. So Oliver Lutkin, that is Bill Magnuson, he was so cunning, he was so clever, he knows how to make money. So first of all, he tells him that we shall go to Fritz's shop. He says that I know Oliver Lutkin, he is a cheat, he is not a good man, and even he owes me some money. I have to take some money from him. So he tells that let's go to Fritz's shop. Now what is Fritz's shop? He says that Mr. Fritz is there and he has got a club, he has got a shop. I'm sure he is playing poker there. Now, what is poker? All of you know, a game of card. A game of card played for money, played with money. So he says that let's go there. So first he goes there and tries to find him. So he tells him that I will go inside. You don't come, because seeing you in lawyer dress, he would escape. He would run away from there. So let me go inside. And he goes inside and asks loudly. So when he goes inside the shop, Mr. Author, he was standing behind little far and he was watching out. He was hearing everything. So he goes and asks for Oliver Lutkin. But the people there, they say that he is not here. He has gone to Gustav's shop. So actually everybody perhaps knew that this is the person who is asking for Oliver Lutkin. And there were many of them, his friends, many of them, they knew him. But in order to support him, in order to help him, or it was his such a tricky technique, such a sharp technique that people couldn't find him out. He had hidden his identity. So people told him that he has gone to Gustav's shop for shaving. Shaving his beard. So again he takes the man to Gustav's shop, but he didn't see him there. And then he just simply gives an excuse by someone, and somebody tells that the man was here, but just before 5 minutes he has left and he has gone to pool room. He has gone to play pool or billiard. And he gives the excuse, let's go and find, and they goes to the place to find him out, but they couldn't find him. Now around 1 o'clock, or you could say the afternoon was over, searching for Oliver Lutkin. They couldn't find him, because Oliver Lutkin was himself who was the hack driver, in disguise of hack driver. But actually the lawyer was a simple, gullible man. He was, you could say, a fool. He was easily befooled by this man. He was a simple man. So now the lawyer said that I am getting hungry, let's go for a lunch and I can buy you lunch. If you don't mind, I can purchase you lunch. So he said, no, don't go to these restaurants. They charge you a huge amount and they serve you the greasy, oily food. Instead of that, you can come to my house and my wife would serve you a good meal, and she would charge only half a dollar for your lunch. So again, he took him to his house. He was very happy with his hospitality, with his kindness, with his kind word, with his etiquettes, a good behavior. So he took him to his house. There they packed the lunch and then they went and sat on a mountain. And from there, they were enjoying a beautiful scenery, a beautiful landscape view. And they were eating their lunch. And after that, he said that now let's go to his house. I think he might be at his house. So Oliver Lutkin, that is Bill Magnuson, who himself was a hack driver, he took him to his mother's house. And actually the mother was also in support of her son. So the moment he went inside, he had already told the mother everything, what has to be done or not. So, and mother was also very, very clever in supporting her son. So the moment he went inside and he said that this person has come, somebody has come to serve someone to Oliver Lutkin. She ran with a iron rod. She had a hot iron rod and she ran after them. She started chasing them, and the lawyer and both of them ran very, very quickly. They left the house and sat in the hack. And now the man, that is the author who had come to serve the summon, he was disappointed. He felt that he has lost. he cannot serve the summon to Mr. Oliver, and he would have to lose his job now. His boss would be disappointed with his task, but he had no option. So therefore, he asked the man to drop him to the railway station again. He pays him the bill, whatever he had asked for, whatever he charged, and the man, Bill Magnuson, drops him to the railway station. From there, he catches the train and returns back to his office. There, he informed the boss that I couldn't find the man. It's very difficult. He is a very clever man. Even though there was a fellow who helped me all the time. He took me everywhere in the city, the countryside, in order to search Oliver Lutkin, but I couldn't find him. I'm helpless. And the boss scolded him. The boss again sent him with another partner, with another one of his colleagues. And he said, since you do not know him, since you do not have his photograph, since you do not have his identity, it's very difficult for you to find him out. But you take the help of your friend and go there. And your friend, your partner, he knows him very well. So he will help you find out him. So along with his partner, along with his companion, he went there in order to search him. And the moment they dropped down from the train, when they were on the railway station, just in order to catch the cab, they went outside. And they saw that this man was there. Oliver Lutkin was there. He was telling something to his mother. And this mother, this lady was his own mother. And now seeing her, looking at her, he asked the person who had come to help find out, the person who had come to help the author to find out Oliver Lutkin. He said, isn't it the same man who had helped you? So the author said, yes, but how do you know? So he said, isn't it the same man who had helped you in finding Oliver Lutkin? So he said, yes, but how do you know? So he says that, idiot, this is Oliver Lutkin, and he has cheated you. He has befooled you. You are a lawyer, but he has cooked his fantasy, his false story, and he has been successful in earning money from you and also befooling you. So at this, he was disappointed, but no problem. Again, both of them, because it was their job, they go to the mother and also Oliver Lutkin, and they serve him the notice, they serve him the summon that you have to come and present yourself before the court, because already you have got notice or messages, but you have not appeared before the court. So finally, they were successful in submitting him the summon. And this way, the story gets over. This way, the task, the job of the author finished. And the author has shared this experience with us. Initially, the author thought that the villager or the village people, they are simple people. They are ordinary people. And he was happy. He was satisfied with the hospitality and the kind words of the hack driver. But he was shocked and surprised and disappointed at the end when he had found out that the hack driver was himself Oliver Lutkin, and he had cheated. So this is the story. Now I hope everybody has understood in my own words, and I don't think anybody has any doubt. Yes, understood or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, now I hope everybody has understood, but we shall still read the story word to word, line to line from the book. So all of you can open your book. Front page, first page of the book. All of you open your book, first page, page number 47. Got it? Yes, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So those who want to read, they can raise their hand. I can read the introduction, then you can take over. Yes. Who are ready to read? Raise your hand. No one? I can't see any hand. Naira Qureshi is there. Okay. Okay. So just I read the introduction and then Naira will take over. Chapter 8, The Hack Driver. A young lawyer comes to a village to serve summons on Oliver Lutkins. A friendly hack driver takes him around the village in search of Lutkins. Does he find who is Lutkins? So we are going to read the chapter about an author and his job to deliver a summon to Oliver Lutkin. Now, when you read the chapter, when you listen to the chapter, keep in your mind the questions which are written here. First question is, why is the lawyer sent to New Mullion? Now, New Mullion is the name of the village, name of the place where Oliver Lutkin was living. So question is, why is the lawyer sent to New Mullion? And answer is that to deliver a summon to Oliver Lutkin. What does he first think about the place? So what does he first think about the place? And what does he think about the place after the meeting, after the experience with the hack driver Bill Magnuson? Next question, you would also get the answer, that is, who befriends him and where does he take him? Who befriends him? Befriend means who becomes his friend, who becomes friendly with him, and what are the places he takes him to? And next question is, what does he say about Lutkins? What does he say about Lutkins to his partner, to his boss? And also, what does he say about Lutkins to the hack driver? So different questions could be there. So first, he told the hack driver that he has come for a work to give a notice, a summon to Oliver Lutkin. And the hack driver himself, Oliver Lutkin, was so cunning, so clever, so sharp that he had asked all the questions, all the queries, and the lawyer was so simple, so gullible that he spoke everything and didn't even cross-check whether the information he is sharing to the person, it is safe or not. So now we read this. Yes, Naira, you had raised the hand, so you can begin. Yes, rest of you, listen carefully, okay? Yes, Naira, begin.
After graduating with our honors, I became a junior assistant clerk in a magnificent law firm. I was sent not to prepare legal briefs, but to serve summons like a cheap private detective. I had to go to dirty and shadowy corners of the city to seek out my victims. Some of the larger and more self-confident ones even beat me up. I hated this unpleasant work and the sight of city life it revealed to me. I even considered feelings to my hometown where I could have been a real lawyer right away without going through
unpleasant. So he even thought of fleeting to his hometown. He had joined the law firm, but he was not given the proper treatment as a lawyer. Rather, he had to serve as a clerk, clerical job, office job, and he didn't like this. He was not happy working there. He he was not happy with the city life. The city life turned to him, the experience he had in the city. So therefore, he has mentioned it here. And he says that he wanted to go back to his hometown, where he could have been a real lawyer right away. But actually, if you have a degree of law, it's not that straight away you would be called a lawyer. No. First, you graduate, you take a degree as a lawyer, and then you have to practice under someone. You have to practice under some seniors, some experienced person. Because in school or in college, you just learn theoretically. You get very less exposure to practical situation. So in college, in law college, a person reads about law, about articles, about different sections. But to some extent, he may practice also. There are the artificial or courtrooms, scenes are there. Courtroom scenes are created, role plays are done, plenty of practice is done. But there is a difference between practice, between theory and a real practice in the court. So therefore, it is mandatory for all the lawyers after taking their graduation or any law degree, they work under some experienced, famous, popular, known lawyer. So he had joined the law firm. He thought that he would learn something. He would be able to solve some of the cases. But no, it was not so. He was serving as a clerk. Yes, continue now. Continue.
So I rejoined one day when they sent me out 40 miles in country to a town called New Mullins to serve summons on a man called Oliver Lutkins. We needed this man as a witness in a law case, and he had ignored all our letters.
So he had gone to a place called New Mullion. Why? To serve a notice, to serve a summon to him, because he had ignored all their notice. Earlier they had sent him the notice to come and present himself, but he had not come. So he thought he was sent to serve the notice personally. Continue.
When I got to New Mullins, my eager expectations of a sweet and simple country village were severely disappointed. Its streets were rivers of mud with rows of wooden shops, either painted a sore brown or bare of any paint at all. The only agreeable sight about the place was the delivery man at the station. He was about 40, red-faced, cheerful, and thick about the middle. His working clothes were dirty and well-worn, and he had a friendly manner. You felt at once that he liked people. I want to told him to find a man named Oliver Lutkins.
Okay, so you could see here the description, the physical description of Oliver Lutkin is given here. What kind of man is he? His age was around 40. He had a red face, cheerful, happy, thick, about the middle age, and he was working in dirty and well-worn clothes. He had a friendly manner. And immediately he had thought that I told him to find a man named Oliver Lutkin. Immediately seeing him, he was influenced by his personality, by his behavior. So he thought that this